Hello everyone, welcome to Let's DevOps. I am Sumit and today we are going to discuss about Azure Bicep. So in this tutorial, first we will understand what is Azure Bicep and why Azure Bicep. Second, we will understand to set up Azure Bicep for a development environment. And third, we will create our first Azure Bicep template to deploy Azure resource. Let's begin. Azure Bicep is infrastructure as a code, which is declarative and domain-specific language to create Azure resources. So it is Azure native and also simplified version of ARM template. Let's understand the benefit of Azure Bicep and why we need Azure Bicep. So first is, it is simpler in syntax. It means you can easily understand by reading the Bicep template. So basically it simplifies the complexity of JSON template, ARM JSON template. Second is, it is a module specific. It means you can write your Bicep template, you can create as a module, and you can refer in your parent child template. Third, it has automatic dependency management. It means you don't have to write your code in a sequence. Based on your dependency, it will execute well execution. And fourth is, it has a rich validation and intelligence. It means that when you write your code, it gives an error and also it gives the suggestions. So let's understand the Bicep workflow. So as an engineer or a DevOps engineer, you will write your Bicep template to create Azure resource. So first you create your Bicep template, and then with the help of Azure PowerShell or Azure CLI, you deploy the Bicep template. And that happens through the Azure Resource Manager. Okay. So now let's set up or install a Bicep on a Visual Studio Code. So first of all, you should have Visual Studio Code. If you do not have, you can download and install from the given link. So I'll open my Visual Studio Code and install the Bicep. Now here I have opened my Visual Studio Code, and from here I need to go to the extension, and from the here I need to search the Bicep. And you need to just click on install. So once you click on the install, it will install the Bicep on your Visual Studio Code. Okay, now you see it's already installed. So once the Bicep is installed, let's check whether the Bicep CLI is available or not. And for that, you need to just type Bicep and then world. So if it is installed, it will show you the version. And if you do not have installed, then you can follow the link in the video description. From there, you can download and install the Bicep CLI. And to run the Bicep, we need to also have either Azure CLI or Azure PowerShell module. And to check that, you can just need to type AG and then version. So if you do not see the version, it means that you do not have installed, right? So again, you need to just follow the link given in the video description to install the AG module. And to check for a PowerShell AG module, you just need to get installed module, and the name is AG. So for me, both Azure CLI and AG module is installed. So that's the reason you see all the version is available. And for this also, if you do not have and you want to install, you can just follow the link given in the video description and also in the blogs. Now it's time to create our first Azure Bicep template to deploy Azure resources. And before creating that, let's first understand the basic keyword to create Azure Bicep template. So first is the param. Param is the value that vary for a different deployment. So basically this is one of the keyword to define the parameter value. Second is the variable. It called as a var. So it is used to define your variables in a Bicep template. Third is very important, the resource. It means that with the help of resource itself, you define which resource needs to be created in Azure. And the fourth is output. It means that if you want to display some output information, you can use this keyword. Okay. Now let's understand how we define this keyword, and then we will understand the bicep syntax. So to declare and define the param, we need to use the param keyword followed by the name and then the type, and after that we can define a default value. For a variable, you just need to use the keyword var, and then you need to give the variable name, and after that you need to assign a value to it. In the resource syntax, after the resource keyword, first we have a resource symbolic name. So it can be the name given by you, and then the second one is the resource type. What kind of resource if you want to create, that you need to give it. And under that, you will define all the resource property. For the output keyword, you need to use output keyword, then followed by the name, and then what are the type, data type of that output, and then under that you will define the value, right? So these are the basics Bicep syntax that you can use while creating your Bicep template. So let's create our first Bicep template. Let's create a Bicep template to create a storage account in Azure. First, I'll add a new file, maybe storage.bicep. So each Bicep has extension of Bicep. If you notice here, you can see this icon also. It means that this file created as a Bicep file. So as we know that to create any resource, we need to use the resource keyword. And if you see here, since I typed res, it has a very nice intelligence. Okay, so after giving the resource, we need to give the symbolic name, and it can be your name, right? So like, since I'm going to create a storage account, maybe I say the st account, and after that we need to give the type, right? So for our case, we are going to create a storage account, so it could be storage account, and you can just tap enter, and then here you can select the API. So latest is from 1st of September 2022. So I'll use that, and after that I need to what to, right? So here we need to define the property, right? So property can be your name of the storage account, location, and others. So if you mouse over here, you'll see there are a lot of details, right? It's saying that to create a storage account, you need to define all this missing information like time, location, name, and SQL. It means that it gives you the type validation. So it gives also you suggestion, okay, if you want to create a storage account, what are the property you need to define, right? So let's start with the name. So assume that if I am going to give name as ST demo 3, and then I have to also define the kind, and kind can be your blob storage. So it sees all the different type, you can see it here. Next is location. So maybe I'll give here as the East US, and then after that we need to define the SKU, right? So SKU is and SKU has the object, so let's give a name, and then here you see. So if you see, this has very nice intelligence, right? For each value, it is giving that all the options, which one you need to select. So let's understand. Maybe let's select the standard ZRF, and after that, we see it is a property, right? Okay, so property is, what is the access here, right? So maybe it's a cool or hot, so maybe I'll use a cool. Now if you notice here, since we define all the property, that the error icon is gone now. So it means that our Bicep template is ready to deploy. So here we only define the name of the storage account, what are the kind, what is the location, and on the location, if you see, it's saying that the resource location should not be hard coded. It means that we can parameterize, right? And that's what we understood. So if you want to create a parameter value, then you just need to use the keyword like param, and then maybe assume that if I want to create for location, and after that I need to define this type, so it is string, And if I have to define a value here itself, then I'll maybe give it a use to it. So since I have defined this parameter, I can just replace this STUS with a location. Okay. So this is the basic Bicep template to create a storage account. Now let's create a Azure PowerShell or PowerShell CLI to deploy this Bicep file. So for that, just I'll use or create deploy.ps1, and with the help of Azure Resource Manager, we will be deploying this by September. So for that, we need to add a new resource group deployment. Here we need to give the name of the deployment, maybe deploy. Template file. So this we can give a reference to this Bicep file, and then that's all. Just we need to run this command, and you'll be able to run it. So, but before running this, we need to make sure that we are connected to Azure. So maybe for that you need to just connect AG account. With that you will be get popped up to log into the Azure, and then maybe if you want to set the specific subscription where you want it to run, then maybe the subscription, and here we need to give the subscription ID, and after that here we need to also give the resource group, right, under which resource group you want it to create. Resource group name, so then that if I want to deploy to demo AD, demo storage, and with the help of this, you will be able to deploy. So, first we need to connect to Azure, and then we need to set the subscription if you want to deploy on a specific subscription, and then after that, we will just run the AG resource group deployment. Okay, so I have also uploaded this script. In that GitHub, you can just follow the link given in the video description. Okay, so I'll deploy this, and then we'll see how it goes. Okay. Now let's first connect to Azure. After connecting to Azure, we need to set an agent context. So currently I have Visual Studio subscription, so I'll just go ahead and run this Bicep. So as you know that to run the Bicep, we need to use the new Azure resource group deployment. So for that, I need to use Azure AG resource group. Then maybe the name of the deployment, deploy ST. After that, I need to give the template file. Okay, so template file, and I have this file storage. And since we are going to deploy this on this resource group, that also we need to define. So the resource group is our storage. So since this resource group already exists, so I have given the name. So now let's run it. You can run this whole thing using the deploy.ps1 also. So that's the reason I have also added this. For deploy.ps1, you can also create as a different variable like template URI and then the parameter URI file. So I have attached this all this deploy. And then the storage Bicep also in the GitHub, so that you can just have for a reference. And since it is running, so let's go and check on the resource group. And here let's go to this deployment, and looks like it's got completed. So let's come here and see. Yeah, so now you can see that it's been succeeded. The provisioning status is it's succeeded. So now we need to go to that. So it's so with the name of ST demo 0103, we should have the Azure storage account created. So let's go here, go to overview, and see here it's been created. So yeah, that's all for the demo. Now let's recap what we learned in this tutorial. So first we learned what is Azure Bicep, why we use Azure Bicep. Second we learned to install and set up Azure Bicep on Visual Studio Code, and then we created our first Azure Bicep template to create a storage account. So in the next video we will learn the different data types supported in Azure Bicep, what is the parameters and a variable, and how you can use in a Azure Bicep template. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any issue or concern, you can write in a comment box. And if this video was helpful, kindly share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Have a good day.